Hi, Leos. So this reading is going to be for singles, for couples, and then for those of you who are in an on-again, off-again relationship or you're somewhere in between, you haven't yet defined it. We're going to start with singles, and then as the video progresses, hopefully I'll be able to just put in the bottom, in the description section of the video, where what you're looking for is going to reside. So if you're coupled, you'll know right where to go into the video. So let's get started. Okay, so for February 2019, with Valentine's Day coming up and everything, what does it look like for you generally, historically, and moving forward? So you might not have had a lot of control, Leos, in regards to the way that things turned out with your relationships, or in regards to maybe not feeling like you could control your partner or control any outcomes. Maybe you were not able to meet the right people and that was somewhat out of your control. Now, however, it seems like by broadening your, it's like you're throwing a bigger net out there, okay? So some of you, you're doing that by maybe you never online dated, now you're starting that. Some of you are likely to meet somebody interesting through travel, or, and it doesn't even have to be long distances. It's not like you have to go all the way to Vietnam to meet your soulmate. It's more like going places you've never been before. You're exposed to new people. That's the energy we're in for February as far as potentially meeting the right person for you. Now, it's saying moving forward, it does kind of seem like some of you are embracing this energy of like, I don't have much control over who I meet or where I meet them or if they're interested in me or not kind of stuff. You're going to want to clear that energy away because it's not serving you. It's not helping you. Now, a lot of you, it seems like while you're casting that bigger net, while you're exposing yourself to different things, new people, you're not going to necessarily be meeting people who are lovers, like, you know, hit it and quit it kind of people. So will they end up to be just friends for you, or will they end up to be, like that kind of life partner energy? It's going to vary because many Leos might watch this. Sometimes one video might have 8,000 views for a certain sign, and obviously it's not going to be the same for every person. That's why personal readings are going to be more succinct and precise and exact, but generally this is kind of the energy for the majority of Leos. Now, that being said, for single Leos. That being said, oftentimes our moon sign is going to resonate better because that's our emotional side, which is where our relationships pretty much live. We make all of those decisions based on, you know, how we're feeling versus what is rational a lot of the times. Well, depending on what sign you are, but most of the time. So if you don't know your moon sign, there's also a link in the description box that'll take you to a place where you can find that out for free. And then maybe it's better to watch your moon sign if it doesn't resonate. Oftentimes things from both of them will. So anyway, that's just a random tangent. But what else is up for Leos that are single in February? And they're saying, whatever it is, like in regards to meeting people, you really have to try hard not to talk about your job, not about what you do for a living. Now, part of the reason for some of you might be that it's embarrassing, or it's, you know, a point of contention, or it's just fucking boring to always hear you talk about your job. But then for others of you, it's like at work-related functions or at work is not the place where you should be probably meeting people who are going to be good matches for you in February. What else? I mean, that just kind of seems obvious, right? The thing is like some of you are putting out this energy that like you're not really excited to meet new people. And that might be because of that energy that we started with where it's like, oh, you know, things didn't always work out the way I want. I couldn't control the trajectory of things. Therefore, I'm a little bit disheartened and I'm not super, you know, enthused or excited about finding a new partner. So people are going to pick up on that vibe if you don't change it. The thing is that you are open to receive love, but that might not be the vibe that you're putting out. The good news is, though, that it's actually harder to change your openness to receive love, your willingness to receive love, and not kind of resist it and push it away. That's really difficult to change. So that's not an issue for you like it might be for other signs. Since you're open to receive it, you'll receive it so long as you're putting out a vibe that you want it. People will give that to you. Okay, so I'm going to switch decks here. I remembered in your general reading for February that Leo's, I believe it was Leo's, had this kind of energy where it was like, if you move around a little bit more, you're going to feel better. There's this kind of stuck energy that you had, and that's taking hold in your body. And so I'm switching decks here to see what you need to focus on in order to meet the right person. And there's two things here. And the reason why I chose this deck is because it's different positions that you can move in. Okay, so sorry for that interruption. It was me as a Leo. That was my opportunity to stand up and move. Block my own, you know, push away my own stiffness. Anyway, so these cards, they have different, I think, Tai Chi movements that will sort of help you with the topic in which they are correlated to. So anyway, they're saying your biggest challenge right now is your perspective. And that's kind of something we already talked about, changing your perception. I don't have time to date. Might be something that you think. I'm too busy with work, so I don't have time to date. Well, if you change your perspective and you say, I would make time for to date the right person, all of a sudden you're opening up a lot of opportunities and you're only resisting energy of people who are not right for you. So anyway, this says that you should guard against your narrow perspective and suppress any negativity. So any negative thinking you have about the dating process, about, you know, finding your future forever person is something that you're going to want to focus on if that's something that you do want down the road or in the near future, okay? Now, the other thing is this energy of the dancer. And I feel like in your general readings, that's what they said. Stand up and dance and move, because it's going to raise and boost that kind of fiery energy that's usually really natural for you, but has become stagnant. And then the other thing with this is that it's going to help you kind of move it and shake it like around, stir up that energy, like I said, with that stagnation. But, you know, I guess I don't know how to articulate this appropriately, but I guess what I'm trying to say is by moving and shifting the energy around in your thought patterns and your processes and going to new places and different things, you're welcoming in all of these different potential opportunities for you and that will create different potential paths and conclusions for you in your life that can be very happy for you and happy and very joyous. You know, dancing for a lot of people brings a lot of joy, a lot of happiness. It gets our energy flowing. So this is something that you might want to make some time for. Whether you take a dance class, you go out with your friends, or you're just like shaking it as you're cleaning your house. That's something that I really like to do. I like to blast the music full blast and pick up as fast as I can. I try to make it a game because I hate tidying. So anyway, behind the dull mask of self-consciousness is the bright fool. And as you know in tarot, the fool energy is this energy of optimism and anything can happen. And like I'm totally protected by the universe and I'm safe and it doesn't matter if something seems risky, it's going to just work out for me and I know that. That's that kind of energy. And this is the direction that you want to be heading in when you're looking for a partner. If you're like, oh, well, I don't want to go out there and date somebody because they'll probably hurt me or they'll end up to be an asshole. Okay, well, you're closing yourself off to all of the good potential partners as well when you do that. You can't control the way that somebody else is going to behave ever, okay? So any fears you have about them, about a potential person that they might hurt you, 90% of things we worry about don't actually happen. And if it happens, you couldn't have blocked it or controlled it regardless. So clearing away those fears is going to be very important. So will the majority of single Leos find love this month in February? Let's see what we get here. And they're saying, the majority of you, no, you will not. But listen to your intuition, because for some of you, if you feel like, yeah, I already know I will, then you will. And listen to your intuition to guide you as to where you should go, what you should do. If you're driving along and you're like, I'm not particularly tired or thirsty, but you have this inclination like, oh, I should stop at this coffee shop, and you don't really know why, follow that, because the universe might be conspiring to put you and another person together. So for the majority of you where they say, no, this is not a likelihood in the month of February, it doesn't mean that's not going to happen in March. It doesn't mean you're not going to meet somebody that will potentially grow into a romance over time. Or maybe you meet somebody, you become best friends with them, and then their brother is super hot, and that's your soulmate. So don't feel discouraged. But what this is also saying is that you need to really kind of open up your heart. You're able to receive, but you are allowing fear to block your energy from shining this beacon out, okay? So here's the deal. If you're not feeling enthusiasm and excitement and joy for your future partner to come into your life, if you're feeling more doubt, dread, you're kind of like, oh, I don't even know that soulmates exist at this point because of your history or whatever. The thing is you're not, you want to imagine your heart chakra, right? Like a lighthouse, like it's shining this beacon out. And it's kind of going like this, okay? And your potential future long-term partner is out there looking for you, okay? So they can't find you if the light bulb's burned out. They can only follow, you know, the light, follow their intuition to meet up with you if you're kind of, you know, open to that. If you're saying, I'm really excited for the day that this happened. I'm really excited for the right person to come into my life in the right time, in the right way. So that's where we want to be with that. Okay, single Leos? Now, moving on to coupled Leos. What's up with your relationship in February? Let's see where it was, where it is now, and where it's going. So here's the deal. It seems like relationships are kind of a struggle for a lot of Leos. The past hasn't always been fair, whether it was you who was unfair to a partner or circumstances or your partner is not being fair to you. Right now, this is creating a very defensive sort of vibe in your relationship. So you're going to want to be careful that, you know, if you're giving criticism, maybe it's not what you say, but how you say it, you know, or when you're receiving it, potentially you want to say, oh, okay, let me help you reframe that. When you say, I don't feel like you make time for me, or I feel like you don't want to spend time with me, what I think you mean to say is, I'm really sad because you've been so, because I like it when you give me more attention. That's how you would help your partner to reframe what you feel like you need to defend. And there might be valid reason for that if that's the case in your relationship. Maybe you're working really hard. Maybe, you know, something's going on with your family. The point is that the conflicts in your relationship are not the actual conflicts, especially moving forward out of February into March. What I see here is you both want the same thing at the end of the day, but you're arguing a lot and bickering a lot right now on how to achieve that. So, you know, let's say you're married. You might want to sell your home and move into a new one, okay? You both agree you want to sell your home, you want to stay married, but you're fighting and arguing over where you should look for the next one, okay? Or maybe you're in a coupled relationship and you both want to get married at some point, but one of you wants to move in together first and the other one wants to wait until after marriage. It could be that sort of a deal. So the point is that these things in between that you're arguing about how to do something, let's not focus on that, because this is creating a lot of negativity that could lead to potential resentment down the road in your relationship, where you want to just kind of start with, okay, what's working for us? What do we have in common? Let's focus there and then try to reframe the way that we're saying things so that we can meet in the middle and find a compromise that works. Or also, even furthermore, picking our battles. You know, why is it important to me that I win this? Do you need to? You know, what is the reason behind that? So as far as, I mentioned for the single Leos that a lot of you might have kind of this stuck energy based on our general readings for February. So I'm using this deck that has like Tai Chi movements in it. And so with this one, it's kind of just putting your hands up like this. But I want to show you the magic of this. Okay, you see how she's like swirling her hands kind of up and around? It'll feel good for your back. Actually, I kind of like that. Point is, hand chakras up to the sky, you know, up to the divine. So as you're doing this, you see all this color energy in the back. This is a good way for God, Allah, the angels, the universe, whatever, to kind of heal you, to run that energy through you. And it's also a way that you're asking for support and help and guidance. And so it says all life comes from the light. And so maybe this is a problem that some of you are having. Maybe you're having trouble conceiving. And so it's like, okay, let's focus on the fact that we both want a baby, and it doesn't matter if whether we are going to argue over in vitro versus adoption. Point is, we want the same thing, and let's focus on that. That's the main point, okay? So asking for help from spirit, from God, angels, Allah, whatever. Is there anything else that we need to talk about for couples in February? They're saying a year from now, a lot of these things that you might be bickering about or arguing about aren't actually going to matter. And that's how you're going to want to reframe a lot of this stuff for those of you who are kind of like in this defensive battle. Ask yourself before you engage in that, a year from now, is it going to matter? If you're bickering over who's going to take the trash out versus who's going to empty the dishwasher, ask yourself a year from now, am I going to give a fuck how this worked out? If not, let it go. Let your partner just have this one. They're saying this will lead, if you're able to embrace that, if you're able to really follow this guidance and work on it, that this will lead to a lot more lusty and kind of passionate, exciting sex life and love life for you. And this is because, you know, the creator of the universe, whatever you believe, is going to be helping you with this. They are going to make sure and provide benefit for you. In this is a lesson that you're supposed to be learning, and everything will kind of just kind of will feel better and come to you a lot easier if you're able to really follow that. Okay, now for those of you in between, if you didn't watch the singles and the couples portion in the beginning, well then it might be a good idea because there might be certain things that click for you. But I mean, if you're a busy person, have other stuff to do, this specific portion of the video is for you. So those of you who are in on and off again relationships, it's not Facebook official, whatever the deal is, maybe, you know, you've got, maybe you're in a relationship with somebody who's in a committed relationship, whatever. What they're saying is that historically, this relationship has taught you a lot of things about how to feel more at peace, more at ease, more calm. Right now, you're in this energy of like non-attachment, and that's okay because it's non-attachment to the aspects of the relationship that are toxic or aren't working for you. I do see that more love, more romance and things like that are coming for you, and they're starting in February, but this doesn't necessarily mean that it's with that specific party, which might be why this on again off again relationship thing is a good thing for you right now. So let's see, what is the likelihood that this is in regards to the on again off again relationship, or you know, the in-between type relationship that each Leo watching this video is immediately feeling? And they say that's the one you need to let go of so that you can welcome in that love, that harmony, that romance, because you're not getting it necessarily the way that you want to at the fullest capacity. Maybe they don't love you in your love language. And it's just like, you know what? Time to let it go so that I can be open to receive all of this other stuff that's better for me. This is why it hasn't become a committed, like, longer term thing. And some of you might say, no, that's not why, there's outside circumstances. Okay, but those outside circumstances are affecting the ability of your relationship to grow and thrive and give you what you need. So even if it wasn't your decision to be in this position of it's kind of committed, it kind of isn't, I don't really know what to call it, doesn't matter. Facts are facts. If you let this go, something else will show up that is better for you. And so they're saying, if you watch the portion that the singles had about this beacon of light that you would be shining, hold up your own inner light as an inspiration to all of those around you. And so as you let this go, you can let your light shine as a beacon where somebody else out here in the universe can pick up on that light and follow it to you. Okay? So that is your love reading for February, and I can't wait to see you in March. Thanks so much for watching this video and getting all the way to the end of it. I really appreciate your support. If you are interested in other videos, click here. If you are interested in subscribing, go ahead and click here. Hit that notification bell so that you get alerted to when new videos come out and also when I do surprise live streams. And then if you're interested in winning a free 20-minute video reading personally every month, go ahead and click right here. Mwah!